Hi, I'm Sandy Graffius. I'm your county controller. Jeannie Tusey, who is normally our hostess, isn't here tonight, but God bless her. She hardly gets a chance to talk anyway, so, you know, this is the way it goes. My folks tonight are from Adopt an Acre. That sounds kind of funny. You can adopt a lot of things. They adopt acres. It's Vicki Kintzer and Dr. Barton Smith. Can I just call you Bart?
Yes.
Is that too informal? Seeing as we went to school together.
For 60 years, you can. After 50 years, you can call me Bart.
Okay, good. Bart it is. Vicki?
Yes.
Sorry, you're too young to know about Albright College.
Yes.
He and I are alums. We could jump up and sing the song, but I forget what it is. I just know Reading High's. I know Fort Square.
Fort,
no, that's all right.
I don't even know that one.
Oh, I do, but I only sing with 20 other women. I sing with Sweet Adelines.
Yes.
But I sing bass, so I don't sing like a la carte. Now listen, we're going to Adopt an Acre because I have so much stuff to ask you. And so just get ready because it's going to be like,
okay.
You ready?
We're ready.
How long are you in business?
Since 2004, we incorporated.
And who started this thing?
Actually, I did with some other people. We founded it because it's a complement to the state and county preservation program, the farmland preservation program.
Well, let me just stop you for a minute because I'll just give them a real quick review on what the county does. We will go around and we will inspect farms for viability of growing crops. They have to have a certain standard that they have to meet, and then they're paid $250 an acre, I think.
No,
$2,500. Oh, I'm just...
that's the
max. I just missed a zero.
Yeah.
Okay.
The max is
$250 to $2,500. How's that?
Yeah. I think the farmers might be a little upset, too.
Anyway, once it's preserved, it cannot be used for anything but another farm. Now, we have that as a county. Now, you did Adopt an Acre, and you started that because...
We started that because I also serve as chair for the Berks County Ag Preservation Board since that's inception in 1988. So we saw the need for preserving smaller acre farms that don't qualify for the state and county
funding. Oh, is that right?
So we started this nonprofit, tax deductible 501(c), and we're trying to get the little mom-and-pop niche farms to get a cluster of farms that are preserved from the county and state.
Now, when you preserve these are preserved always be farmlands. They can't be anything else. Is that it?
Well, some can be. We have some woodland. Same as the county, there are some acres that could be woodland, too.
But they're not going to be sold and become housing projects.
Oh, absolutely not.
Okay, I think that's the bottom line.
Yes.
Okay. Where do you get your money?
From donations from anyone.
I know, but you don't stand in the street corner with a red bucket, do you?
We're almost at that point. But we do have memberships. You can become a member for Adopt an Acre. Our membership starts at $45.
Okay.
Anything on up, but at this point, you know, we'll accept any donations that anyone wants to give
us. When you become a member, it's because you're more concerned about preserving our land than having it developed. Is that correct?
Correct.
And so you would like to give $45 plus. We'll always go plus, and then
yes.
that gives us. It's the same thing like the $250 and $2,500. They can go $45, $4,500.
Yes.
Yeah, you just keep adding zeros. But $45 is the least.
Well, we'll accept almost anything. But
no, don't lower your standards.
We do have a student membership that we just adopted because we're trying to get the students involved, like the FFA, those types of things. So we just adopted a student membership of $10 a year.
Okay, that's fine.
So we could get the FFA and Agri students.
Now, how big is your board?
We have 9 members on the board.
And how often do you meet?
Once a month.
Okay. Do you get any funding at all from state or local municipalities or the county or any governments?
No.
So no, you're raising strictly. Everything on your own?
Yes.
And when you do this niche for these smaller pieces of land, how small do you go?
Well, Barton's the president for this year, so we're...
What do you do? Set it as you come in as president. Okay, I'm president this year. You're going to be one quarter of an acre. No, I'm only kidding.
Well, we're working on 10 acres at a time.
Okay. So you would like to have 10 acres and no less?
Yes. Minimum of 10.
Which is fine. This is not a test. Mm. Why? What do you want to say? This is your chance to talk for 2 seconds.
Well, let's say we have 10 acres.
Okay.
And we're going to pay someone $1,200 an acre.
Wow.
We have to raise a lot of money.
You're darn right you do. You better get...
$45 won't cut it.
Yeah, you better add that zero.
Yeah.
At least. Now, how many acres do you have reserved now?
Oh, I would have to approximate because we did a joint venture with the county and the state.
Okay.
On one of the farms that is preserved from the county and the state. I think that was over 100 and some, but we didn't purchase the entire farm for Adopt an Acre. We gave a certain amount to complement that. And
how
then we had one other farm.
How do you decide what's going to be preserved? Who makes that decision? Would that be Bart over here?
No, we have written criteria.
Okay.
Which I won't bore you with.
No,
but
just give me a thumbnail.
Well, the land, there has to be some farming going on.
Okay, well, that's the first thing. Or forestry going on, if it's forest land, right?
It can have.
So something's got to be growing there.
Right.
And it can't be dandelion.
Yes.
Right.
It's got to be more than that.
We have certain criteria on how we score it, same as the county and state do, but not as extensive as their scoring. But we do follow a scoring pattern to pick the farms.
And you're telling me you pay $1,200 an acre.
Well, that's ostensibly
that's
our limit.
Okay.
We might offer that much.
Okay.
Now, and if you have 10 acres and you want to preserve it, you can take nothing and donate the easement.
I understand.
Okay.
I understand.
Yeah.
Do you get a lot of that?
Well, we haven't done a whole lot, but we do get it, yes.
Good. You know, that shows a good heart for the person that owns the land. And I'm not trying to be smart, but they are, in essence, giving over to you guys the right to do anything with their land beside what's being done right now.
Well, not really true.
Right. That's
Why?
Not true, because it can really, as is the state and county program, it can only remain in farming. It can't be developed, but it has to be productive. So
I didn't mean
let it go to ruin.
No. I didn't mean that you didn't do anything with it. I meant that they were willing to hold that like that and grow things on it for the rest in perpetuity.
Yes.
Do you go on to the deed the same as with the county?
Yes.
So you become part landowners of the deed like an easement?
Yes, it is an easement that we put on.
Okay.
But we're not landowners. We just hold the deed restriction.
Correct.
No.
Go ahead. Don't let me intimidate you. Go ahead.
Well, there are certain advantages even if you donate the
easement. Tell me
if
what?
If you don't get paid for these. Well, they're tax advantages.
And which are what? I'm not trying to be smart.
Tax deduction.
Really?
Depending on the value, after appraisals are done, and there is a formula by which the owner of the land, having added the easement, will obtain a tax benefit.
Year after year?
No,
or just once
and
done. I think it's once, or they phase it in. I think the federal government phases it in over maybe a 5 or 10 year period. So what he's talking about is if the land is appraised and the easement value is $2,500 and we pay a maximum of $1,200 or whatever we can afford and negotiate with that landowner, they have the ability then of claiming the portion up to the appraisal price of it as a tax deduction. That's the same as what the county and the state program is.
Okay,
as well.
I understand. So what they do is they get a tax break
for
whatever value the land is valued at above what you're giving them.
Right.
How am I doing?
Great.
Now,
better than that.
Beside your $45, how else do you raise money? Because you'd have to get a lot of $45 as is.
Well, we just got confirmation that we're going to be doing a charity breakfast over at the Dairy Queen in Kenhurst on September the 12th. So we're going
come
to be, you know, further information to come as we get information, but we just confirmed the date. One of our big things that people don't know about, which we've tried to put on our Facebook page, and we need to get on the website, is we have a charity. Our charity is marked on Amazon Smiles. So if you have an Amazon account...
I don't know what that means.
Okay, if you have an Amazon account, okay. You buy things on Amazon.
Oh,
which
I'm
most
the Amazon
of the people,
queen.
Right. Mm-hmm. Well, then you need to help us out.
Okay.
So you have your regular account with Amazon, but when you log in to purchase things, you actually log into Amazon Smiles, one word, .com. And it'll say, what charity do you want to support? And Adopt an Acre is listed.
Get
you click
out.
On that, and we get 0.5% of the sales.
Oh, man, I'm like a gold mine for you.
Well, please.
I mean, first of all, I have books and movies that don't quit. That's the first thing.
Yeah, so anybody can help us even without becoming
and so
a member.
And so you go www.amazonsmiles, is that what
That's
you're saying
it.
When you sign on?
AmazonSmiles.com, yes.
Same range of products are available. Whatever you buy now, and if you subscribe to the Amazon free shipping option,
yeah,
that can apply too.
How'd you get on that?
Apply.
They actually found us.
They
because someone suggested us as a charity, and then we've signed up for it and gave them all the information that they needed.
And gave them the paperwork.
Yes, you have to prove that you're
a charity.
501c3.
Yeah, I understand. And then that's what qualifies you to get in there. What do you get? One?
We get 0.5% on the sales.
Wow, that adds up.
Yeah, good.
It does.
And how many people know that?
Not very many. We've tried to put it on our Facebook page. We try and put it on our literature that we go out. If we go to fairs, if we have, we've had restaurant events. We just had an event at Austin's where Austin's was willing to give us, we passed out coupons. By way of the coupon, they were willing to give us 20% of the check.
No
which
kidding.
We did that event. And
who do you have out there tramping these streets doing this? Is that you?
That's the problem. We have no network, per se, other than our members. So
okay.
We rely on our members, and unfortunately, you can't just keep asking the same people. So this is why we're grateful for your program, because it gets our charity out in the open.
Yeah.
We really don't have any advertising. We have limited resources to advertise, to, promote the things that
we do have.
So
yeah.
We also sell giant gift cards.
Oh,
they're
I know.
$50 a gift card.
Oh, I know.
But when you,
You have to eat.
I know.
You have to put
I
gas
got,
in your car. So
between Miss Amazon and Miss Giant, you...
Let us.
If I go ahead and do the Amazon Smile, I'll take care of your whole budget.
Well, that's
for the year
great.
For you.
we'll get the cards to you.
Well, honey, I have somebody in my office that sells them to me.
Yes.
Okay.
And then I get.
Share. One month
it.
Them and next
this,
month us.
This little message goes out. Who needs a giant card this week?
Well, we get $2.50 on each of those
cards.
Wow,
that's great.
So the more we sell of those cards, the better off we is, and it's kind of a cycle. You're buying food. You're preserving farmland, so it's a cycle.
Sure. I have no problem with the giant cards. I shop there all the time anyway. Now, how many volunteers do you have?
9 board members, and then if we have other activities, we ask our friends and relatives whether they would help us out.
Do you have a sign-up list? Do you have a list of people that are sitting around waiting for you to call them and say, we need help doing blah, blah, blah?
We would have them either send us an email at adoptanacreinc@aol.com, or they can call the office. I believe our number was being posted, but it's...
Yeah, did we post their number? Could we... Oh, look at that.
Oh,
as
great.
If by magic.
By magic. There we go.
Get out your pencils and papers and copy down that phone number and call them up and tell them you want to volunteer.
Volunteer?
We'll put that back up in case you didn't... Or grab a pen and write it on your hand. But we'll put it back up for you.
Yeah.
We went rather quickly over the Amazon Smile business. Again, anyone, if you are buying anything from Amazon, it's the same outfit, go to Amazon Smile site.
So you're just
And then you have to designate Adopt an Acre. They will ask you to designate who is the beneficiary of your purchase from Amazon. You can do
but
it
it's not changing
times.
Your price, it's not changing your shipping, it's not changing anything.
No.
They're just sharing that piece of the
that's
profit
right.
with
right.
you.
That's right.
Because every big company does a whole bunch of good stuff for people,
right.
and that's part of the good stuff for people they're doing.
Right.
Is that right?
Yes.
That's correct.
Okay.
Yes.
Now, when you have volunteers, what are you going to do for your breakfast over at Dairy Queen?
Well, we don't have any formal information on that. We're working on that. We just got the date confirmed so that we could lock that in.
That's Kenner's, did you say, Kenner's?
Now we have to negotiate the actual details
of
when the breakfast is going to be.
That's over at the Redner's lot, isn't it?
It's 6:25 and 7:24, yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
And so you're going to have breakfast there, and then you're going to get part of the
Yes, from the ticket sales that we have.
How'd you make out at Austin's?
We made out well. We made out well. We got a couple hundred dollars from that.
Did you really?
Yes.
How much?
300.
Good job. That's almost as good as 10 members, huh?
We're bits and pieces. That's, you know, one of our problems. We
need a lot of income. Somewhere you got to get a big number from something.
I know. So we need some sugar daddy or sweetheart or somebody out there to, you know, give us a grant and say, go out and preserve that farmland.
Is anybody writing for grants? I don't know. I personally don't happen to know how to do that.
Yeah, I'm very limited on how to do that. As we are networking, we're trying to find somebody, to keep our website up to date. It is very outdated, which is a shame, but, you know, a lot of us don't have the savvy to get in there and know how to update it. We had someone design it, and now it's up to us to maintain it, so...
And that's not easy.
It's not. So
that's not easy because we have a website for the Sweet Outlines, and nobody knows how to fix it.
I know.
It's a bugger.
That's one of the problems, and if it remains outdated, people lose
interest. I think that should be your, you know, push here. You look like a techie.
Thank you.
Are you?
No.
Okay, that took care of that one.
You know, we should get back to the idea of why we're here.
Why don't we?
For a while there was a motto floating around, no farms, no food.
Oh, that's interesting.
Now, I'm a city boy. I went to school here on 13th Street, lived on 12th Street. My only connection to the farm was my uncle, Curtis, lived in Kutztown, worked for the farm implement dealer, Nittles, up there. And when I was so high, he would take me along. He'd make farm calls to fix the machines out in the farm. And this was one of my first memories. And then I got interested in bird watching. So that's how I sort of got sucked into this job and ended up in just a few short years as president. Can you imagine? The city boy, 12th Street.
I don't think you want to say sucked in. I think you want to say you were in... like motivated to become involved.
I was motivated to become involved because I look at not only as food, but there is what we're preserving is scenery. Okay, for example, Hawk Mountain.
Yep.
You go to the North Lookout, climb up the mountain and look out there, and it's beautiful now. But if that land is developed, it's not going to be such a hot view.
Hey,
so
when we were
they're
kids,
made scenic easements now.
Before we did Hill Road,
yeah,
that was all rural land over there.
Oh, yeah.
And when I talk to my grandkids about that, they can't picture that because...
The dairy farm on the corner.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, we could ride a bicycle out to Bernhardt's and go fishing
absolutely
in the summer.
Absolutely. And the niche that you guys are filling is the smaller pieces of acreages.
Yeah, that will get lost.
Yeah.
But to finish what I was saying about the scenery, and there's wildlife. So one of my thoughts about this organization, Adopt an Acre, is that when somebody wants to donate an easement to us, it might be possible, and I'm hoping that my friends at Albright Biology Department can get into this, to evaluate it and what unique biologic properties that piece of property might have as well, as well as the farming.
I mean,
the farming is a legal requirement. We have criteria for that. But, maybe we should rate it on scenery and wildlife and wildlife value as well.
That would be tough.
And they all have
that. That is so tough.
All of these. Well, it's a pie in the sky. It's a dream. But I think it holds true, even if you're not doing the evaluation, that what we're saving is scenery and wildlife.
Yep.
As well as farmland. Since January.
Oh, you're a newbie.
Yeah, sure.
He's a newbie.
Yeah.
I've been around since 2004.
Still right behind years.
But he's a newbie.
But he's so passionate.
He is.
So you've been on the board a while.
I have to tell you that this agency would not have lasted from 2004 to date without the 9 passionate people that are on this board, because we struggle. Because even though we're 11 years old per se, we're still considered new in the charity world.
Well, not only that, you're one of the best kept secrets.
Yes.
You know, if it weren't for Mr. Giant Carr over there, who works in my department.
Yes.
Not mentioning any names, Scott Polk. You know, if it weren't for that, I wouldn't have even been brought into this whole process. And really, I didn't know anything about your organization. I knew it existed only because of you.
Right.
But I really didn't know about it. What's your budget? What's your budget for the year?
Well, we have very minimal expenses. We have no paid staff.
Okay.
We do have an office up at the Wernersville State Hospital. We have an agreement with the state.
Is that donated for you?
It's pretty much donated, yes.
Okay.
So we pay a minimal for utilities, and we have our insurances. Other than that, we have stamps, but our expenses are almost less than $1,000 a year because we really don't have
anything. So you're certainly not wasting money on that. You don't have an overhead that you have to worry about.
No. Whatever we are getting in is primarily used for preserving farmland.
Okay. You have to be doing more than just having breakfast. And do you have big things like black ties or stuff like that? Or don't you have the people around that can plan that kind of a grandiose?
We could plan it, Sandy, but the problem is how do we reach the people, you know, to get them to come? Because other agencies have a budget for advertising. Other agencies have a huge mailing list.
I really admire you guys. Boy, you're really swimming upstream, aren't you?
Yeah, I mean, if we could partner with another agency. Now, the Conrad Weiser FFA, they do a fruit sale in the fall.
I don't know what FFA means.
Future Farmers of America.
Thank you. I also was born and raised in the city on Fairview Street.
So was I. I'm a Schuylkill Avenue girl. So city people, but we're all passionate about farming. I mean, I wouldn't be on the county board for over 28 years if I wasn't passionate
about it.
I didn't have a farming background whatsoever.
Or me.
But, you know, so it's just that if we even could partner with another agency to have access to, you know, a broader group of people. I serve on the board of the food bank, which one of the reasons I hopped on that was because it coordinates with preserving farms. That's how, you know, food's going to be donated.
That's correct.
So it kind of full circle.
I would like them to put the blue sheet back up again in case somebody wants to call to be a volunteer. And is somebody there all the time to answer the phone? Do you have an answering machine?
We have an answering machine.
That's fine.
Yes.
Please write that down, that phone number, in case you would like to volunteer. And do think about going on www.amazon.smile.
Amazonsmiles.com,
like smiles.
Yes. All one word, amazonsmiles.com.
Because if you are going to shop anyway, to get these people money that way is wonderful. And anybody that wants giant cards, call Scott Pope, for crying out loud, he drives you crazy.
We are grateful, because I'll tell you, he's been selling quite a few of them.
Yes,
so
I know, a lot of them to me.
We're very grateful. He's the king of the sales.
Well, he's insidious. He sort of sneaks up on you.
Well, that's
good.
Giant cards, and it's like, oh, here comes again these giant cards.
Well, we appreciate it, because like we said, we get $2.50 off
that's
of
wonderful.
Every $50 card, which is good for us.
Yes. Now, when you get to a certain amount, that's when you start looking for farms, or you look for farms ahead of time, and then when you get the farms, then you look for the amount. Which comes first, the chicken or the
egg? We have 8 pending applications.
The farms come to us.
Yeah, the farmers come to
us. The others come to us. So we really have 8 lined up.
So people know about it that want to come and preserve their land. You just need the money coming in from the other people to pay for it.
Yes.
Oh,
and some of it's referrals and information from the county that don't qualify for those the program. They refer it over to us, and then they can apply with us. But our problem is the funding, you know.
I can't tell you what a pleasure it was having you folks with us. I know we're going to sit. What didn't I ask? Because we have like 1 minute.
I think it should be mentioned how successful Berks County has been in the program. I mean, tops in the state and tops nationwide.
Preserving
farmland.
We have 684 farms preserved, over 68,000 acres. We'll be over 70,000 next year. We're third in the United States. So Berks County really is passionate about farm preservation.
Well, that's because we love to eat.
Yeah. Well, that's one way of doing it.
No farms, yeah. No food.
Yeah. We love. Yeah. Oh, you love that slogan, don't you?
Yes.
And when he's done with that, then he's going to start in Hawk Mountain.
There was a good editorial in the paper last week about talking about how China bought the pig farming and how they're growing the pigs here, but they're shipping them over there to be packaged. And the USDA allows them then to say, the production and...
I hate to do this to you, but we have to say goodbye.
Well, that's okay.
Thank you so much for being with me tonight.
Thank you.
AmazonSmile.com. Everybody get on it.
Thank you.
Adopt an acre.
Adopt an acre.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good job, Tom.